HBO just released a new Perry Mason trailer. Perry Mason was a very popular TV series in the late 50s into the 60s. It was adapted from a book. It was so popular, they had a radio series, movie, and the TV series. That was the most popular iteration of the character. HBO is doing a limited series, a Perry Mason reboot, based on those books, starring Matthew Rhys, who you would have recently seen in A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood. So Perry Mason, this remake, takes place in 1931 Los Angeles. Here's the premise. While the rest of the country recovers from the Great Depression, this city is booming. Oil, Olympic Games, talking pictures, evangelical fervor, and a child kidnapping gone very, very wrong. Based on characters created by Erle Stanley Gardner, the limited series follows the origins of American fiction's most legendary criminal defense lawyer, Perry Mason. When the case of the decade breaks down his door, Mason's relentless pursuit of the truth reveals a fractured city and just maybe a pathway to redemption for himself.
Did you say a child kidnapping gone wrong? How Yes. can a child kidnapping ever go right?
That's a great question. A question that I feel like we shouldn't explore too much in this video. So, Ellen, you just watched the trailer right before we went live. What did you think of the Perry Mason trailer?
I was intrigued. I liked the whole vibe of it. The main character seems interesting. Mm-hmm. And that one woman loves to yell stuff about the devil a lot, which
That's
is pretty
right.
cool.
Tatiana Maslany, I believe is the actress's name. She does like to yell a lot. And she did. That was the kind of scene in the trailer that I thought could have been really cheesy and over the top. I thought she sold it, though. I think she did a good job in that sequence. By the way, I asked my dad what he thought of the original series because he watched it back in the day. And the word-for-word review I got from him was, it was good. It was on TV. And then he said the books were better. But anyway, my first reaction watching the trailer is that it was more emotional than I expected. I did think that they might be laying it on a little bit thick. It kind of reminded me of Lego Batman, the I only wear black or sometimes dark gray. You see him getting tortured, and then you see him in a room all by himself just screaming because of how frustrated he is. Hopefully, it just comes off a little bit over the top because it's a trailer. They may have just taken a lot of those dark scenes and cut them all together. So when you see it in context over the course of 8 episodes sort of parsed out, maybe it works a little bit better. I will say the actor, Matthew Rhys, perfectly captures the I'm super dark and I have a bunch of crap going on in my head. He wears that on his face really well. He literally frowns. And I find that in the real world, people don't often literally curve their lips in a downward frown style. So he perfectly captures that. I thought it was funny. While you were watching it, I knew you were going to react to the sequence. You said, oh, I like this war flashback.
Oh, yeah.
Anytime there is a war sequence in a movie and The Irishman, you always get excited about that. What's with that one?
I don't know. I love World War II, that whole vibe.
Right.
Love it.
Yeah, I think for me, it's just so ripe for emotional resonance. When you see war and you see how it impacts a person's life, it's just so ripe for dramatic content.
There's something about characters with PTSD from a war that makes them very interesting.
Right. It's a struggle that's interesting to watch. And it also highlights that this will be an origin story for Perry Mason. By the way, Xavier Lee in the chat says, yo, what's up, guys? What's up, Xavier Lee? Thanks for joining. Chime in if you've had a chance to watch the Perry Mason trailer, or if not, go watch it quickly. Come back, tell us what you thought of it. I did roll my eyes a little bit at all the conspiracy stuff. You're saying the police are involved? The cops, the church, everybody. It feels like anytime there's a detective show, it always spirals into some grand conspiracy. But I'll give them benefit of the doubt. And Perry Mason was one of the OG detectives. So if they're pulling this from some of the original material, I'll go easy on them. That's everybody else was stealing from them, not the other way around. Also, great to see Robert Patrick, the T-1000 from Terminator 2, getting a good role here. He was only in the trailer for a few seconds, but it's always good to see him back in action.
I never remember his name. Every time I see him, I just think John Doggett.
John Doggett. Who's John Doggett again?
It's behind you, man.
John Doggett. from, oh, X-Files. Yeah. That's right. Yeah, he was introduced late in the game, late in the series as Mulder's, basically Mulder's replacement. So I have high hopes for this show. All eight episodes are directed by Tim Van Patten. He directed episodes of Boardwalk Empire, Black Mirror, Deadwood, Game of Thrones, The Pacific, The Sopranos, and The Wire. So he's got an incredible resume. I also love when you have one director doing an entire series. Mm-hmm. That's when you get a singular vision. That's when you get consistency and quality across every episode. David Fincher directed, I think, the first two or three episodes of Mindhunters. And I didn't watch that series except for, I think, the first couple of episodes. And from what I hear, once he leaves the show and hands it off to other people, there is a change in the vibe, a change in the quality.
Yeah, I saw season one of that show. Mm-hmm. I thought it was great.
Yeah.
Season two kind of lost me a little bit, though.
Yeah. I mean, I watched a couple episodes of season one, liked what I saw. I think the show's kind of in hiatus right now. I don't even know if it's coming back. But any other thoughts, Alon, on Perry Mason?
No, I love the whole detective vibe, and I hope it's good.
I'm ready for another detective show. It's been a while since I've gotten invested in a hard-boiled classic detective investigating stuff. Can't wait. And that comes out, I believe, June 21st next month. So look forward to that. We'll be covering that show here on One Take. So make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon so you get notified the next time we go live, the next time we talk about Perry Mason.